This is Daisy Margaret.
In today's video, we are about to discuss Class 8, Unit 18, Organization of Life, Book Bag Questions and Answers. Choose the best answer. Dash is tough and thick white sheet that protect the inner parts of the eye. Option A, sclera. Option B, conjunctiva. Option C, cornea. Option D, iris. The answer is sclera. Sclera is tough and thick white sheet that protects the inner parts of the eye. Second one, dash cells are specialized cells that can be transformed into any kind of cells. Option A, nerve. Option B, stem. Option C, heart. Option D, bone. The answer is option B, stem. Stem cells are specialized cells that can be transformed into any kind of cells. Third one, maintenance of constant internal environment of the body is known as dash. The answer is option A, homeostasis. Maintenance of constant internal environment of the body is known as homeostasis. Fourth one, in absence of oxygen, glucose is broken down into dash. Option A, lactic acid. Option B, citric acid. Option C, acidic acid. Option D, nitric acid. The answer is option A, lactic acid. In absence of oxygen, glucose is broken down into lactic acid. Fifth one, the process of air passing in and out of the lungs is called dash. Option A, inhalation. Option B, exhalation. Option C, breathing. Option D, none of these. The answer is option C, breathing. The process of air passing in and out the lungs is called breathing. Sixth one, osmosis is the movement of water molecules from a, option A, higher concentration to a region of lower concentration. Option B, lower concentration to a region of higher concentration. Option C, both of these. Option D, none of these. The answer is option A, higher concentration to a region of lower concentration. Osmosis is the movement of water molecules from a higher concentration to a region of lower concentration. The erythrocyte is placed in dash solution, which has a lesser concentration of solutes and greater concentration of water than in the cytoplasm. Option A, hypertonic. Option B, hypertonic. Option C, neutral. Option D, acidic. The answer is option A, hypotonic. Fill in the blanks. First one, cell is the structural and functional unit of living organisms. Second one, the largest cell is egg of an ostrich. Fermentation is a good example for anaerobic respiration. Fourth one, optic nerve is located at the end of the eyes behind the retina. Fifth one, the size of the cells are measured in units of microns. Match the following. First one, carbohydrates. Second one, glucose. Third one, protein. Fourth one, amino acids. Fifth one, fatty acids. We have to match the correct answer for the given questions. The answer is carbohydrates, glucose. Glucose, carbon dioxide, water and heat. Protein, amino acid. Amino acids, enzyme, hormone, protein. Fatty acids, cholesterol and other steroids. State true or false. If false, correct the statement. First one, in hypotonic condition, concentration of the external and the internal solution of the organism are same. False. The correct statement is The concentration of external solution is less compared to the concentration of internal solution of the organism. Second one, diffusion is the movement of particles from an area of lower concentration to higher concentration. Answer is false. Correct statement, diffusion is the movement of particles from an area of higher concentration to lower concentration. Third one, human beings are warm-blooded in nature. The answer is true. Fourth one, the larynx has fold of tissue which vibrate with the passage of air to produce. The answer is true. Fifth one, aqueous humor plays an important role in maintaining the shape of the eye. The answer is true. Answer very briefly. First question, what is cell differentiation? The answer is, our body develops from single cell called zygote. The zygote undergoes mitotic division to form many cells of different shape, size and content. These cells attain change in the structure and function, which is called cell differentiation. Second one, state different types of tissues. The answer is, depending on the basis of their structure and function, tissues can be classified into four types. Epithelial covering tissue for protection, muscular contractile tissue for the movements and locomotion, connective supporting tissue for binding different structures of body, nervous tissue for conduction of nerve impulses. Third one, mention the function of alveoli. The answer is, alveoli are tiny sacs in the lungs. They are the workhouses of the respiratory system. The exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide take place in the alveoli of the lungs. Fourth one, name the processes by which air enters and comes out of our lungs. Answer, the process of taking air into the lungs is called inspiration or inhalation. The process of expelling air from the lungs is called expiration or exhalation. Fifth one, differentiate between osmoconformers and osmoregulators. The answer is, there are two major types of osmoregulation. Osmoconformers, these organisms try to maintain the osmolality of their body matching with their surroundings. Most of the invertebrates, marine organisms, are osmoconformers. Osmoregulators, these organisms maintain their internal osmolality, which can be extremely different from that of the surrounding environment through physiological processes. Sixth one, define metabolism. The answer is, metabolism is the sum of chemical reactions by which living organisms sustain their life. Metabolism consists of anabolism, the buildup of substances, and catabolism, the breakdown of substances. Answer briefly. First one, define prokaryotic cell. The answer is, organisms in which no true nucleus is seen are called prokaryotic. Example, bacteria. Tabulate the difference between aerobic and an anaerobic respiration. Aerobic and anaerobic respiration. First one, aerobic respiration takes place in the presence of oxygen. Anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. The end products of the aerobic respiration are carbon dioxide and water. The end products of anaerobic respiration are carbon dioxide and ethanol or lactic acid. The third difference, common in all higher plants and animals. In anaerobic respiration, common in certain microorganisms and human muscle cell. Third one, why the human eye is compared with camera? The answer is, the human eye can be compared to a camera as both functions by gathering, focusing and transmitting the light through the lens for creating an image of an object. The iris of the eye controls the size of the pupil depending on the amount of the light entering it. The pupil is like the eye hole of the camera, which allows light to come in. Lens, it is transparent and adjustable part of an eye made up of protein. The lens, with the help of the cornea, refracts light focused on the retina and therefore creating images on it. The retina consists of photoreceptors and converts light rays into impulses to be sent to the brain. It is light sensitive. The retina is compared to the film in the camera. Fourth one, which organ and organ system help to maintain homeostasis? The answer is, homeostasis is a property of a human biological system where the self-regulating process tends to maintain the balance for the survival. Behavioral and physiological responses are two important regulating mechanisms that maintain the stability of homeostasis. All the processes of integration and coordination of function are mediated by nervous and hormonal system. The liver, kidneys and brain, hypothalamus, autonomic nervous system and the endocrine system help to maintain homeostasis. Answer in detail. First one, draw the structure of human eye and label its parts. So this is the diagram of structure of human eye. The first part, aqueous humor, cornea, this is pupil, and here the lens, iris, conjunctiva, ciliary body, sclera, retina, fovea, optic nerve, vitreous humor, suspensory ligament. Second one, explain osmosis with an example. The answer is, osmosis is the movement of solvent particles across a semi-permeable membrane from a dilute solution into a concentrated solution. The solvent moves to dilute the concentrated solution and equalize the concentration on both sides of the membrane. The movement of the liquids in and out cells is dependent on the concentration of the solution surrounding it. There are three types of situations in which this could vary. First one, isotonic. Here, the concentration of external and internal solution of the organism are the same. Second one, hypotonic. Here, the external solution concentration is less compared to the concentration of the inner solution of an organism. In this case, water will rush into the organism. Third one, hypertonic. Here, the external solution concentration is greater than the concentration of the inner solution of an organism. In this case, the water will rush out of the organism. Example, red blood cells. When red blood cells are placed in hypertonic solution, water flows out of the cell faster than it comes in. This result in shriveling of RBC. On the other hand, if RBC is hypotonic, more water will flow into the cell than out. This results in swelling of the cell and followed by bursting. Third one, if the RBC is placed in an isotonic solutions, the flow of water in and out of the cell will happen at the same rate. Third detail, differentiate between inhalation and exhalation. The answer is, first, inhalation. The muscles of the diaphragm contract. The diaphragm grows downward. The volume of chest cavity increases. Air enters the lungs through the nose. Exhalation. The muscles of the diaphragm relax. The diaphragm goes upward. The ribs move downwards. The volume of chest cavity decreases. Air goes out of the lungs through the nose. Fourth one, explain about the types of metabolism with an example. The answer is what definition we wrote for 2 mark, the same thing, metabolism. Metabolism is the sum of chemical reactions by which living organisms sustain their life. Metabolism consists of anabolism, the buildup of substances, and catabolism, the breakdown of substances. Anabolism. Anabolism or constructive metabolism is all about building and storing. It supports the growth of new cells, the maintenance of body tissues, and the storage of energy for use in the future. During anabolism, small molecules are changed into larger, more complex molecules of carbohydrate, protein, and fat. For example, glucose to glycogen and other sugars, amino acids to enzymes, hormones, and proteins. Catabolism. Catabolism or destructive metabolism is the process that produces the energy required for all activity in the cells. In this process, cells break down larger molecules, mostly carbohydrates and fats, to release energy. This energy release provides fuel for anabolism, heats the body, and enables the muscles to contract and the body to move. Example, carbohydrates to glucose, glucose to carbon dioxide, water, and heat. Fifth one, explain the mechanism of breathing. The answer, first point, the process of taking air into the lungs is called inspiration or inhalation. Second point, during inspiration, the sternum is pushed up and outward and the diaphragm is pulled down. Third point, this increases the volume of the thoracic cavity and the pressure decreases. Fourth point, the air outside the body flows into the lungs. Here, exchange of gases take place between the air and the blood. Fifth point, the process of expelling air from the lungs is called expiration or exhalation. Upon exhalation, the lungs recoil to force the air out of the lungs. Sixth one, the intercostal muscles relax, returning the chest wall to its original position. Seventh point, during exhalation, the diaphragm also relaxes, moving higher into the thoracic cavity. Eighth point, this increases the pressure within the thoracic cavity relative to the environment. Ninth point, air rushes out of the lungs due to the pressure gradient. This movement of air out of the lungs is a passive event. Higher order thinking questions. First one, why do we need instant energy? Does glucose give that energy? Explain. The answer is, Energy is needed for performing day-to-day activities of the body, which is got through intake of food. This provides energy for all organ systems. Instant energy may be required in the cases of extended physical activities like running or physical ailments like tiredness or giddiness. Glucose is the simplest form of carbohydrate. Intake of glucose helps it to solubilize in the blood immediately and is carried out to organs of the body, thus helping to provide instant energy digestion of carbohydrates and also converts it into glucose finally. Second one, how are they preparing pickles? What are the causes involved in that? The answer is, pickles are prepared usually by addition of excess salt. The salty solution creates higher concentration, that is hypertonic, in the external medium of the vegetable or fruit, which is used for making pickles. Therefore, water comes out of the vegetable and it undergoes plasmolysis and begins to shrink. Third point, thus, when water content is lost, the pickle is able to retain its shelf life for a longer period of time. If you like the video, please do like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.